Now on 9, more talk about the summer surge that doesn't show any signs of slowing down, leading to a spike in the people getting tested for COVID. Hospitals are feeling the strain, and some people wonder if the grocery store is even safe.
Over the next 90 minutes, we're going to look into all of this for you more closely, along with a local town that's pushing back against mask mandates and one school in South Carolina that's debating if it should require masks. First, North Carolina reporting 8,620 new cases of COVID today, the 10th highest daily case count since the pandemic began. 3,552 people are hospitalized and 883 people are in the ICU fighting COVID-19, the most we've seen the entire pandemic. Some hospitals in our area are now having to divert other patients to different hospitals because they're just running out of room.
Our guest and county reporter Ken Lemon was the only TV reporter to get a look at how this is affecting EMS response times and their ability to get people who are in need to a hospital. Ken?
Yeah, and Scott, first of all, that term diversion, that simply means that the hospital is so busy or so full that they need time, new admissions to catch up here. But because of that surge in COVID cases, it is happening more often, and medical officials are saying, please do not come to the ER unless it is a medical emergency.
It was heart-wrenching to see him suffer like that.
Tammy Byers said her 19-year-old son had severe symptoms and later tested positive for COVID. She went to the ER, Care Mountain, Gastonia. It was peak period. Resources go to the most ill first.
Stressful. We were there 4 hours.
He was able to get pain medication at another hospital. He is in quarantine at home. Hospital workers say cases like that are the reason why they're asking people to go to urgent care or their doctor first.
The pandemic impact in my community and the region and the state has been very significant.
A Caremount spokesperson said 10 hospitals throughout the Charlotte region have gone on diversion in the last few weeks. COVID greatly contributed to that. In early July, there were as few as no cases at Caremount. Today, there are 92.
They just created this.
Medics and hospitals are now using this system to track diversions at 29 hospitals. It shows when a hospital is on diversion. There was just one when we started the interview. A couple of minutes later,
Piedmont Medical Center went on diversion just as we're sitting here. It's been as many as 8 prior to the creation of this dashboard. It would have been more red than green.
Those hospitals are full almost every day these days.
The chart with real-time updates help medics plan ahead. Every diversion costs time in the field.
But now we're going to CMC Maine, and that turns a hour trip into 2.5 hours sometimes.
Now, Caremount and other hospitals say just a couple of things. Number one, diversions are temporary, and if you are in urgent need of help, they will not turn you away. Caremount did produce a guide to help you understand how to come in safely without swamping an ER. You'll find a link to that guide on our website, WSOC TV.